Right now we're going to have a look at an exciting new feature inside of Photoshop. I apologize for the sound quality. Right now I'm in Hawaii, but I still want to make this video for you. Let's have a look at an exciting new feature. So we're going to click here. It's going to be in the Actions panel. And if you don't see it on there, you're just going to choose Actions from Window. Now what it does is it actually analyzes the photograph, and then based on the photograph, it offers us some suggestions of different actions that it could run on that photo to make it better. So here's the thing that's really interesting, is if I roll over and just give it a moment, notice what it does is it actually runs the action there in the background in the Actions panel so it can give you a preview. And then notice as I roll over the next one, it gives me a preview of what could happen on that. Now, if you want to get more suggestions, what you can do is go see based on your image and then just hit refresh, and then it'll give me more options here. So let's see what the background blur would look like. Okay. Notice as I roll away, it will preview the next action. Now, if I want to apply an action, I just simply go to the action and then just click. And it will apply this action. And there we go. We've got the blur background. Now, I noticed something on here. What they didn't do is use content aware fill to get rid of the edges, which is why we've got those weird blurred edges. I'll link to my tutorial, which will show you a better way to blur the background. But notice it creates a new layer, so we can, if we don't like it or we don't want to use it, we can just delete it. Now, there's other things in here. Apart from having the actions in there, we can also click on yours. And when I go under yours, this shows me my actions that I've created. Now, as you notice here, it's not going to give you a preview on your own actions. All right, so let's go back to the suggested actions. And here we have suggested, and we can keep refreshing these, and you'll get 15 different suggestions on each photograph. And then you can, you know, just choose one that you think is going to work for you. The other option is we can go under the featured, and we'll see featured actions here. But it gets better. So say we want to do something with color, we can go up into the search bar, and we can type in color, and now it's going to bring up all these different actions that are available with the word color in them. And as we roll over these, we can see previews. Now, not every action is going to give you a preview, but the majority of them will. Let's see what the pop art effect looks like. Okay, that's kind of interesting. Now, what if you wanted to see a list of all of the actions? Well, that option is not actually available, but here's a cool little hack that I got from Pete Green at Adobe. If you go here and you enter a spacebar, it's going to create a list of all the actions with a space in there, and you can see we have a lot of different actions in here. So this shows us a lot of the actions that are available here inside the Actions panel, and you know, we can apply any of these. And as you can see, oh, the H photo actually looks quite good. All right, and then to reset it, just hit the little X there, and we go back there. Now, under the actions, you can choose here, we can choose classic actions, and this will take us back to our actions, which I have in button mode right now. So I'll just go here, turn off button mode, and there's the actions, like what you're used to. So according to Adobe, this is just the start. This is a work in progress, and more features are going to be added soon. So stay tuned for another video coming very soon where I show you all the new features that have just been released inside of Photoshop. And drop a comment underneath. Let me know what you think about this new actions, and any questions or anything like that, drop it in there too. And if you're new, welcome to the cafe. Hit that subscribe button, turn on notifications so you don't miss any of my tutorials. And until next time, I'll see you at the cafe.